हेलो एंड वेलकम बैक ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल पार्थ दोषी लर्निंग बाय डूइंग। सो दिस वीडियो इज गोइंग टू बी एन इंटरेस्टिंग वन बिकॉज इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट आर द बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस दैट यू शुड फॉलो व्हेन यू आर क्रिएटिंग अ कस्टम एक्टिविटी यूजिंग द लाइब्रेरी टेम्पलेट और कंपोनेंट दैट वी हैव इन UiPath स्टूडियो। सो इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू how you can create a simple activity, not just creating an activity, but what are the different types of best practices. Like development, we have best practices for development as well. In the similar way, there are best practices for creating this library component as well, which I have identified through my experience and I thought why not make a video on this as well. So let's get started. Now, when you open UiPath Studio, here is the library component you can see. Create reusable components and publish them together as a library. Libraries can be added as dependencies to automation process. So we are going to do the same thing. We are going to create a library component and we are going to build a simple activity along with seeing what are the best practices to be followed. Right. So when you click on this, now the name that you see over here, here itself, it's important start. Why naming, giving a proper name is important over here, I'll shortly let you know. So the name that you give over here is going to be your package name. For example, when we go to activities. So this particular thing that you see, programming. So this is the library name that you give. Within this, there can be multiple branches, right? So this can be the subfolders within that. But this main XAML that we are creating right now is the name over here. So make sure you give a correct name over here to your library project because it will reflect when you are using it within other process. So here is the first important best practice that you need to follow. So I have already created a date time. As you can see, I have named it date time and I have given a proper description as well. Set of activities for date time operations. Okay, so now within that, let me just do one thing. Let me close the solution and I'll reopen it. Okay, so now again, a small difference over here that I would like to highlight is when you open a normal process, the main XAML file, right, is already opened in the designer canvas over here, as we can see. But in the case of library, it does not happen that you have to manually go and open the XAML that you want to. So this is just a minor difference that I would like to highlight. Now, what activity I am creating over here? Okay, so when you will create a library component by default, this name will be as new. So you have to right click it, click on rename, and you have to rename it. So what my activity name is, get business days between two dates. Okay, so this is going to be my activity name, as we can see within the date time package. So if I search over here, let me go over here. So if you see, this is computer vision, and within that we have CV check, CV click, and all that. In the similar way, within my date time, it will be get business days between two dates dot XAML. Now here, this is the second best practice, that you give a proper name to your activity so it is user understandable. And then you right click it and I think you need to go to properties. Yes, go to properties and here, give a description to your activity. Now, whenever you see, if I highlight, just hover, add custom logs, log fields to each log message. So this description that you see is added through here. When you right click this and when you go to properties, you see this particular description that I have added. This is the same description. This activity is used to get the number of business days between two dates. So you need to add over here and you can add any help link if you want to. But in our case, it is not required. But if you have any documentation for that, which you have already hosted somewhere, a Google Doc link or anything, SharePoint link, you can put it over here. But in our case, we don't require that. So till now we have seen three things: naming our package correctly, giving the right name to our activity, giving the right description to our activity. Now, every activity has some inputs and has some outputs. So how are we going to write them? For that, you need to create arguments. In arguments will be the input parameters. Let me just drag a activity, which is, let's drag a read range activity. A workbook read range. Okay. So now this you see, input parameters are the input arguments, output parameters are the output arguments, right? So when you come over here, you see there are three arguments created. The first one is date one, date two, and there is an out argument, which is number of days. So basically what my this activity is going to do is it will take two dates as input, right? And it will give me the number of business days between both of them. So you can write business days, number of days, anything you can write. Why I have written number of days is because in my description, I have already written of the activity that it is going you to give, it is going to give you the number of business days. So in this way, create this input and output arguments, whatever you think, with the valid argument type. So this was the fourth best practice, creating the right input and output arguments. Now, it is very important that you add annotations to each of your argument. If I right click this and go to annotation, start date value. Okay. And this is end date value. Note date two should be greater than the start date. Okay. So why I have written this now? Again, let us drag this activity. If I hover over here, range specifies the range of the cell to be read. If this value is not specified, the whole spreadsheet is read. If the value consists of only one cell, the whole spreadsheet is read starting from the cell. Okay. So this kind of descriptions, if you want to add to your own custom activity, you need to add annotations over here. So in this, I have added one annotation. In date two, I added a note as well. Now, why did I add a note? Because let's suppose if I'm putting my date as 2nd December 2021. Now, if I want to get business days between two dates, so I should put a value which is higher than this. Otherwise, I will be get. Otherwise, the activity won't throw error, but the output might not be correct and it might give us a negative result because the date will be prior to 2nd December. So in that reason, if you want to add any note, you can add it in this way. Now, third. Number of days, number of business days between date one and date two. So now if you see here, each and every part, we have clearly specified why are we taking this input? What is this output? What processing we are doing? What is this activity used for? Now, in many cases, we have seen UiPath activities have required input fields. How you can do that is if you click on this, you see here is a checkbox called as is required. Check this. Now I want my input to be always required, date one and date two. Otherwise my processing won't happen. And my output, I want to keep it as number of days, but I do not want to keep it as required. So if I click on this, it is not as required, right? It depends. Logically, it should be required because user has to get the output if he's running the activity. But if he doesn't create a variable, I don't want to force user to create output variable, right? So it is completely up to you. You want to make it as required or you don't want to make it as required. So in this, now we have seen how you can add description to your input and output arguments as well, right? So this was the, I think, the sixth best practice that we saw. I lost the count, but I think this was the sixth best practice that we saw. So this is how you should create your library components. Now, if you want to add a description over here, now what I've done is my complete processing is happening within this one invoke code. So this is not something this is like, this should always be this, right? It can be anything. It is completely up to you, right? But this is how you should create a library component, right? You should add description to your activity, right? You should add description to your input and arguments. You should give a correct name to your activity. Now let's use this activity within one of our processes. So what you need to do is you need to just simply publish this to your local folder maybe. Yeah. So this is my local folder where I have already published it. Now I'm going to go back to, okay, let's go to this one. Okay. Have to manage packages, develop date time. Yeah, here it is. So if you see over here, daytime set of activities for daytime operations, right? You can see the description over here. Install. Okay, there is one more best practice that I have missed telling. We'll shortly go back to that. Let's before that install this activity. Let me open a test sequence. What I'll do is I'll create another sequence. Daytime testing. Now in my activities, if you see over here, yeah, here it is. Daytime. This is what we named. We could add a space as well, but we didn't add that space. Now, if you see over here, get business days. This activity is used to get the number of business days between two dates. Now, if you see how very well it is mentioned, I'm going to double click it. Date one is my input argument. Right. So I did not publish latest one. So let's publish this latest one because before this, it was not is required, but now we have made that. So let's publish that one. Okay. Now, also one more thing. Now here, we are not dealing with mail package. You have to uninstall it. We are not dealing with UI automation, neither we are dealing with Excel. So if any package that is not required in your library component, do not keep it as it is. Remove it if it is not required. Let's click on save. Now I'm going to publish it. Next and publish. Okay, now let us go to forum solutions. So I hope you found this video helpful. Yet the video is not completed, but just I hope you found this video helpful and now you can create the, now see there is an auto upgrade available because I have mapped the paths. And if you see over here, dependency is only one, uipath.system.activities, and I'm going to install it. So these are the very minor best practices, but when you are working within an organization, right? And when you have been told to create a reusable component using the library component, these are the things that you need to take care of. If you didn't know, you can add a description over here and it is not like user understandable, then it might, you know, happen that in code review, they ask you to add all this and you are not aware how you can do this. So this is how we are going to do this. So what I'm going to do over here is I'm going to do daytime dot now. Okay. Why is it not taking that? Let me click on this. Let us go to this. Daytime dot now. System dot dot now. Okay. So maybe because of naming convention or something like that, there is that problem. Now dot. Okay. So let's keep as it is. And here it is going to be system dot date time dot now dot days let me put 15 days and my output is going to be, so this is, I'm just showing how we can test our activity, a log message. Let me save it and let me execute. So what I have done is from today until next 15 days. So I have added that 2 days, and what is the, so today is I think 2 and next 15. So that is still 17. So if you see over here between 2 and 17, how many business days are there? So it is 3 and 6. So till 17, there are 11 business days between them. So it has given me this output that my one particular invoke code is doing this. So in this way, you see, this is how you can create a reusable component, which exactly fits your requirement, which is easily user understandable, and you can use it very smoothly within your process. So I hope this video helped you to learn something new, like not only to create an custom activity using library component, but what are the best practices that you should follow at an organizational level when you are working as a senior developer or a developer or any other development part. I hope this video helped you. Thank you for watching the complete video. Please hit the subscribe button if you like the video and share it with your friends. Thank you for watching the complete video.